Hello, thank you for joining me in this talk today. My name is Sarita Schoenebeck, and I'm going to present work that I did with my colleague Paul Conway at the University of Michigan. And let me start by asking you, what do you think of when you think of an archive? Do you think of maybe the Library of Alexandria? Maybe you think of the National Archives in Washington, D.C.? Maybe you think of something like the Bentley Museum here at the University of Michigan, where I am. But have you ever thought about something like Google as a kind of an archive, or even Facebook as a kind of an archive? What I want to talk about today is how technology companies have become kinds of archives, and people who work there in the companies have been archivists, and what that means for how we think about ownership and control and power over who manages our data. So let's start with a question. Have you ever thought of what kinds of digital records of your own you might want to store? Would you want them saved forever? Would you want them deleted at some point, forgotten? And who should control that data, and who should make decisions about that data? The choice of what to save or what to destroy, and in what form and under whose authority, is known as something called archival appraisal theory. Archival theory has roots in record-keeping practices and in the theory and practice of preserving, organizing, and providing access to records of human history and societal knowledge. But what does it mean that large technology companies now are making those kinds of decisions? In a sense, essentially, they've become archivists of our personal and our societal records. They are arbiters of what societal knowledge should look like, and who should have access to that knowledge. But often they do so based on large-scale automation and algorithmic curation, giving an impression of neutrality and objectivity. What I want to talk about is how archival theory can lend insight to where that might introduce some concerns. So this project takes the agenda of expanding archival theory within the field of computing within CSCW. Early archival theory treated archives and records as objects that were neutral and objective. And archivists were thought to be passive curators of knowledge, people who simply managed information that was out there in the world and treated it in a neutral manner. And around the 20th century, there emerged what's known as postmodern archival theory. And this now recognizes that archives and archivists are subjective curators of knowledge with immense power and control over who gets to decide what is knowledge and what is not. And archival scholars have taught through this idea of decolonization of the formal archive because they're suspicious of records assembled by governments and institutions like records of Native Americans in the United States or of South African apartheid or of Cambodian genocide, for example. And in this project, we are thinking about, well, what does it mean that technology companies and the people who work there are now arbiters of social knowledge and of our personal digital data? In this project, we drew from older adults' perspectives about their own data and how they might want it saved, preserved, do they want it permanent, what do they want to be forgotten, precarity, and exploring how we might think about who should control this data and make these kinds of decisions. We make the argument in this paper that technology companies are exerting the power of archivists without the cultural or professional mandate to preserve a public good. And that's the argument we want to make, is that they should take on that mandate of being curators of a public good. And our research is a small indicator of a growing disconnect between what people might think their personal archive is and what happens to the pieces of those digital data when agency and control are dispersed across technology platforms and across technology companies. If you have any questions, I'd love to hear from you. You can email me or tweet me. Thank you for watching.